we need to snatch them out of the fire through compassion.
Yes.
So that they can follow us to move to where we are going. In the name of Jesus. Listen. You are crossing over. What may tonight and this very afternoon, God shall cause you to cross over in the name of Jesus. Somebody, if you believe it, be on your feet and somebody make a trumpet and say, I will cross over. Somebody say, I will cross over. Somebody say, I will cross over. Somebody say, I will cross over to the other side in the name of Jesus. Somebody listen, you are staying at where you are for far too long. You need to take a step into the other side. And God is lifting somebody's feet to the other side in order for you to make it. You will cross over. You will cross over to the other side. One day, look into your Bible, Mark chapter 4.
Yes, yes.
The book of Mark chapter 4, verse number 35. Ah, thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. For Father, come what may. Hey, this very afternoon, now, this late evening, oh God. Come what may, we shall cross over. For the Bible says that it doesn't matter how fortified the walls of Jericho was, God allowed the Israelites still to break through.
Yeah.
They break through and they pass through the city. Somebody, I'm telling you, I don't know what is in front of you. I don't know the barricade. I don't know the obstacle. I don't know what is hindering you to cross over to the other side, but you shall make it.
Hey!
I said, somebody, you shall make it.
Hey!
I said, somebody, you shall make it.
Hey!
You shall break through both physically and spiritually.
Yes, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. What are they saying? That you will mark time forever. No, you are not going to mark time in the same place. Listen, there is a saying that a great man or a philosopher put it, he said, the place at which you are at to create a problem, you don't stay in that same place to solve that problem.
No.
Do you understand it? If you are standing here and ants are biting you or mosquitoes and they are all over this place, brother, you need not to stand here again. You need to what? Another territory, because maybe in that territory there is going to be peace, there is going to be unity, there is going to be tranquility. So you don't stay in that same problem to solve that problem. And somebody listening, I don't know how big your problem is, but God is about to lift your leg from that problem to the other side, to the other side, to the other side, in order for you to make it. Don't stay down. You are moving.
Yes.
And cross it over.
Yes.
To the other side.
Yes.
What are you talking about?
Cross it over.
Bless you, brother.
Yes.
Bless you. In the name of Jesus. Look into your Bible. Mark chapter 4, verse 35. I read from the King James Version. And it says, and the same day, when the evening was come, he said unto them, let us pass over unto what?
Yeah.
Oh, come on, somebody. Look into your Bible with me. I want to read it one more time. Somebody, are you there? Come on, somebody, are you there?
Yeah.
If you are not there, say, Lord, help me. Mark chapter 4, verse 35. And the same day, when the evening was come, he said unto them, let us pass over unto what? The other side. I love the spirit of Jesus.
Amen.
See, it's not a man that is stagnant. He doesn't become stagnated for a very long time in a particular place.
No.
He has only 3.5 years to work on this head, so he's got to move on.
Yeah.
Somebody, are you hearing me? Church of God, listen. The church is not a monument. It's a movement.
Ah.
Wow.
The church of God is not a monument. It's a movement. And somebody, listen. I want you to know that you have become a monument for a far too long. You have become a statue. And you are not taking any step. But it is my prayer that this very afternoon, as you hear this word of the Lord, God will take you to the other side. The other side where there is peace. The other side where there is resources. The other side where there is everything now and every possible
yes
aspect of breaking through.
Amen. Amen.
You are the church. And you must move.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Tell to somebody and say, don't become a monument.
Don't become a monument.
Come on, one more time. Tell the person, don't become a monument.
Don't become a monument.
Become a movement. Hallelujah. Somebody, are you here with me? In the name of Jesus. Don't become a statue. When you see the statue of liberty, it doesn't move. It stays there. And if you go to water, New York, today, it is staying there. It has stayed there for years. And for some of you, that is what your life has become. You are always lifting your hand and you are showing other people direction, but you are not taking any move. But God is here today to let you know that you are no more going to be the statue of liberty, but God is going to make you to become somebody in order to move into your breakthrough. Somebody, if you believe this, I want you to shout, yeah! Side.
Yes.
And somebody listen to me, whether you like it or not, when the Spirit of God move, I can feel the anointing, I can feel the power, my goodness, all over me. Somebody say, anointing shall break the yoke, anointing shall bring you to a place of no mere men, but you will sit among kings, you will sit among presidents, you will sit among senators, you will sit among great and great and great men, because it is anointing that paves the way.
Amen.
For greater things to be done in your life.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Don't become stagnant. Other than that, you will stink. Do you understand me?
Yeah.
Have you ever seen a ditch where a water is collected for a very long time? What happened? It stinks.
Yeah.
To some people, that is what their life is becoming.
Yeah.
I am here to charge you this morning.
Yeah.
And look, no, don't become stagnated in that particular area. For if you stay there for far too long, you will stink. But God is going to cause a channel and a rill so that rivers of living waters shall flow through your bosom. And somebody, you will arise to possess your possession. I said, do not become a monument. A movement for God.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Before a movement,
amen,
you need to cross over.
Amen. Amen.
And somebody, you cross over.
Yeah.
By the end of this message, somebody, you will cross over.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Please, all movements you see, please. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My youngest Abraham is. Look at your Bible. Jesus said, let's pass over onto the other side. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship. And there were also with him other little ships. Some of them listened to me. And there arose a great storm of wind. And there arose a great storm of wind. While Jesus said, let us go to the other side. And they were about to make a journey, and they sat in the ship. Not long whilst they were on the surface of the water, all of a sudden there was a boisterous wind, and there was a storm that is shaking the ship left and right. Somebody listen to me. For you to make it to the other side, you will step into obstacles. You will come to a place where it seems like, my goodness, my life is stuck. I don't know whether I'm going or moving forward. The storms of life will blow. Have you ever realized or considered where at the point in time it is like, nobody minds me? Why am I here alone? Why do I feel like I am empty? I can't even hear from God. I can't even see anything. I can hear somebody talking to me. Somebody listen. The storms of life shall definitely come to pass in the name of Jesus. And I decree and declare that may every storm in your life be broken. In the name of Jesus, somebody listen, leave that to the light now. I see an angel standing behind her because yes, she was so pleased. Listen, somebody, I want you to know and understand that in life, no matter what you will do, storms of life will come.
Yes.
Oh God.
But he doesn't stop you
That's right.
From reaching your destination.
Yeah. Lord, hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
Somebody, you understand me?
Oh,
it doesn't want to stop you from reaching your destination. The fact that I'm traveling to Florida and I have a flat eye doesn't mean that I shouldn't continue my walk, my journey. I have a spare eye. Somebody, are you there with me? I said you got a spare eye and you can change it and continue your journey. And that is why there is wisdom. Somebody, you have a spare eye. Who is Jesus? If you lean on him, he will take you to your final destination. Somebody, are you there with me? You will make it to your final destination, for you shall definitely cross over.
Hey,
hallelujah.
Glory to God.
I am crossing
Amen.
Over.
To the other side.
Amen.
To the other side.
Receive it.
Some of you, you speak, but it doesn't come to pass.
Yeah.
Today, God shall change your speech.
Yeah.
Today, God shall change your confession.
Yeah.
I declare unto you that may your confession change, that the power of God will follow the way for signs and wonders to happen in your life. The storms of life shall always come.
Yes.
And do you know what happened? Sometimes when storms began to blow, some people give up.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
Some give up. Why have I come? Or I rather become a Christian, and what is happening is that I, my goodness, I'm going through this. Look, when I was an unbeliever, these things doesn't even happen to me. Have you talked to you like that before?
Yeah.
Come on, somebody, are you here with me?
Yeah.
What is it that I'd rather become a believer? And these things all are coming around me. Lord, please save me. Lord, please help me. I don't know where all these storms of life are coming from. Father, I feel like I've been dejected and rejected. Lord, but I need a restoration. You are my restorer. You are my shield. You are my buckler. You are my refuge. Lord, step into this situation. Father, why is it that everything seems as if I am falling down? All hell is breaking loose towards my direction. God, do something in my life. God, please intervene. God, please intercede on behalf of me. For this storm, I cannot. But somebody, I got good news for you. For every storm and every temptation, every trials that you face in life, God always has a way of escape.
Yes.
I am feeling your pain. And I am here with you. I want you to know that God always have a way of escape.
Amen.
Always. Don't give up.
I won't.
Don't give up.
Storms will blow. Does it mean that it will stop our Lord
Amen.
From reaching her destination?
Yeah.
Because Jesus said earlier on, let us go away to the other side. And as long as he has spoken, it means that he must get toward the other side. Somebody listen, your words carries weight. Whatever you speak, that is what comes to pass. And therefore, do not, you see, people that are not straightforward are not strong in leadership.
Yeah. Come on. That's
right.
Leaders are people, when they make a decision, they work towards it and speak
right. Yes.
Great leaders,
yes.
That's what they become.
Yes.
You understand me?
Yes.
Hello, somebody, are you here with me?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness. That is what makes you a leader.
Commitment.
That is what makes you a leader.
That's right.
Commitment, perseverance,
yes.
Diligence,
yes.
Discipline,
yes.
Determination, yes. Making a decision and working towards it will carry you into your delight.
Yeah. Your delight.
It will carry you into your delight.
Yeah.
What are you talking? My goodness.
Yeah.
She will go to the other side.
Man.
The devil part is over. The devil said, oh, if I bring a storm into the life of Jesus, I know that their life is over. I'm gonna drown them in the sea. I'm gonna make sure that they have said they are going to the other side, but they cannot make it. Some of the listen, once you sit in here, your other side is that you will become a lawyer, you will become a doctor. One day you are purpose that you will become a civil engineer, you want to become a pilot. That is your other side, and that is what you're dreaming of. That is what you are thinking of. It is possible. Somebody, I'm here to tell you it is possible. No matter how the stuff blow, don't give up and don't become a monument. Don't become stagnated. But please, somebody, press on.
Yes.
Press on.
Yes.
Towards the high call of God. Press on.
Yes.
Press on.
I will.
I am here to strengthen you this morning. that know that the other side of whatever your dreams and your aspiration and objectives are, it is possible. It can be accomplished. Even though it is not easy, the storms will blow. We will see when the storms are blowing, will you stop? Hallelujah.